What's up, guys? It is 9:01 a.m. U.S. Pacific Daylight Time here in Los Angeles. Tuesday, August 10th, 2021 A.D. Not C.E. It is A.D., guys. And I have, it is Men's History Month. Happy Men's History Month. Last month was White History Month. Happy White History Month. Belated, for those of you who may have missed it. And I have a Men's History Month song. I feel that these are Men's History Month friendly, this music that I'm about to play for you, or I have Chris play for you. This is called Rivers Underneath. It's from the 1999 album by Stavesacre. Stavesacre's a manly band. Except I looked into the guy's Twitter feed, and he's kind of a dumb liberal, but I still like him. I like his voice. Mark Solomon is the singer to Stavesacre. Shout out, guys. But Rivers Underneath from the 1999 album, Speakeasy. Enjoy. I know I will. Some of you actually might enjoy this. It's kind of long, though, so let's get right on with it, and I'll talk you through it. It's like 6 minutes long, but I think you might like it a little bit at least. And we'll get on with the show, guys. Rivers Underneath by Stavesacre. And I'll have a little bit of the lyrics on the screen. I mean, the lyrics are supposed to be on the screen. They will be. Assuming this all works out. It's not Minuteman. That's a miss. I pointed at the wrong song. Exactly what this song is about, but it sounds like loneliness. Is it me? Is a man supposed to be lonely? No. I prefer 90-pound wuss, but I kind of like it. Some guy says, this song stinks. It was okay the first minute. Yeah, Broski Bear, I can relate. Sometimes these songs drag a little, but I appreciate it. They're looking for manhood, right? Looking for manhood. 1999. Morning, Miklo El Chicano. I like the bass line too. Very, very moody. Nirvana was better than this in a dress. That's messed up. Yeah, I like his voice. If Tool and Linkin Park fused, this is what we would get, says Free Ross. Okay, Hake, it was pretty good, but you can go ahead and end it now. That's enough. Almost done. That's the hint. Very, very moody. And indeed, the singer is a liberal. Well, thank you for bearing with me on that, guys. I really like it. But let's get right on with the show!
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la.
Fine. I will be taking your calls, but I have a lot of clips to get to. And I actually have 3 Staves Acres songs to play for you today. That was one down, 2 to go. So like what, another 12 minutes of Staves Acres music? That moody music will mess with your brain. And he didn't say mess, he said a different word. Yes, Ghost Rider, that is true. Is Hake part Colombian? No, but I know too many Colombians now. Well, can you know too many Colombians? Depression. Yeah, not good. You know, somebody said, I dig it, reminds me of Soundgarden, says Cheesehead69 over there on trovo.live/TheHakeReport. And where is Soundgarden now, right? Isn't the singer from Soundgarden that wasn't the singer Chris Cornell? The guy from Soundgarden and Audioslave, and he killed himself, right? I'm pretty sure he hanged himself. Either right before or right after that Linkin Park guy killed himself with 6 kids. He had 6 kids. He's a father of 6, married father of 6, and he killed himself. Psh. That's why I say that a lot of this more moody, grungy white music is, if you want to call it white, it may not have... You know, it's basically the whites went once they've been subverted and demoralized, right? They kill themselves. Miserable. Reminded me of Collective Soul. Was that a Christian band? I heard somebody requested Smashing Pumpkins. Did that guy turn Christian? Did the Smashing Pumpkins singers turn Christian and start Zwan? Or was that Christian at all? Or is he a Christian? Billy Corgan.
I don't know that he turned Christian.
Okay. Who knows? Maybe Chester did not kill himself. He was suicided, just like these Capitol officers. Some think. Some speculate. I don't know. A lot of police officers are killing themselves. They have bad marriages. They're not mentally and spiritually strong for the challenge that they face. Although, how challenging is, I wonder, that Capitol, cushy Capitol Police job? I wonder. I know the D.C. is a mess. Anyway, I talked about that yesterday. I have to get to a super chat from streamlabs.com/thehakereport from Misty Moriton, which came in yesterday, basically in the middle of my show, and I did not see it until the end of, after I went off air. Soundgarden was a beta 90s emasculated version of Black Sabbath, says Odin Sire. Interesting. Interesting take, man. Thank you. Congrats, the Hake Report has been recognized, says Misty Moriton, in a super chat on Streamlabs, by angrywhitemen.org, who obviously hasn't listened because it's angry black men calling to argue. Indeed. And I have some angry black men calling right now, I think. I don't believe one word Joe says about being a businessman. He's always in bed when he calls. He is Sleepy Joe. Referring to Joe from Phoenix, Arizona. Joe from Phoenix, you can either confirm or deny whether you are in bed when you're calling into my show and whether you are a businessman. I don't know. I didn't catch him saying that he's a businessman. But I know that he is helping young people who have like a troubled past get hooked up with like developers. I don't know if they're just building houses or what, but building stuff to live in, right? Affordable housing, supposedly. A do-gooder, but also an evil person. A hate-filled, lie-loving, Obama-loving person. I was going to say Trump-hating, but he always denies that he hates Trump, even though he didn't vote for him and he thinks that he was not a good president. But, so I'll give him that. Single mom doing her best also gave a couple of super chats on streamlabs.com/thehakereport and said, whoa, Hake is one good-looking 40-year-old. Ladies, watch out. Whoa. Thank you. Also, referencing this Stavesacre song, Stavesacre being this Christians in a band or Christian band from the early 90s through early to mid-2000s and a little bit to this day. Maybe in 2017 or 2016 they put out another album. Crowdfunded.
To this day!
Single mom doing her best compares in a super chat Stavesacre to a mix between Pearl Jam and Tool. Yeah, a little bit. My introduction to Pearl Jam was that, oh, where could my baby be? The Lord took her away from me. She's gotten to heaven, so I've got to be good. So I can see my baby when I leave this world. Because it was a cover song. It was originally done, it's like a folk song almost. It was originally done where this guy's taking his date out for a car ride. They're on a date, and then a crazy crash happens. He survives, but his girlfriend is killed. So he has to do good so he can go to heaven, he thinks. And that was my introduction to Pearl Jam. I believe Creed was a Christian band. Yeah, that guy, at least the lead singer, was sort of a Christian. A son of a preacher. I will get to your calls, guys. You know, yesterday I talked about this. I'm going to skip down to clip 15A and B. One of you guys, I think you gave me a super chat over there on trovo.live/thehakereport. Shout out, guys. Nice to see you. Nice also to see the people, the Facebook crew, FBC. Dang, take a call, says A. Owens. Be patient, man. I will. Matt the American says that's a great song. Yeah, I like that song. You're referencing that Pearl Jam cover of that song that I mentioned? Andy No on Twitter. He tweeted this out over the weekend. Shocking video recorded in Portland show a large group of Antifa. Antifa! As Trump says. He mentions them at the rallies sometimes, or over the years he has. Antifa! Carrying shields and weapons, move in to attack and shut down a family Christian prayer and worship event on the waterfront in Portland, Oregon. Because I think there's a river that runs through Portland. I didn't realize that Portland is actually kind of inland. It's pretty inland, right? It's pretty far inland. It's like, it's hot in Portland. I was thinking, oh, it's on the coast because port, right? I thought it was Portland, but no. It's like a good hour or two or something, feels like. Felt like forever. I went up there one time. A few times, actually. But I guess it's a river running through there. Police did not intervene, says Andy No. And I have the clip that he shares. It wasn't taken by him. He shares it from somebody else. Of Antifa attacking the Christians. And look at these Christians. And tell me whether they were showing up for a fight, because there's some dispute about what the nature of this group was and what the nature of their gathering was. Give me a break. As if it justifies Antifa attacking anybody. Very low standards for Antifa, right? Give them a pass. Let them attack. Oh, they're far right people. Let's find to attack them. They're Nazis. Give me a break. Hake with the shiny forehead. Watch this, and it's ridiculous. And if you're listening, I'll try to describe what's going on for the audio podcast and live audio player only view listeners. It's ridiculous. Clip 15A.
Why are you mad?
What is that?
He has
Antifa, a bunch of people in black. He's mad at something. Antifa guy shout. Don't talk to them. Don't be like, why are you mad? Don't talk to them.
What the fuck's happening?
Oops. Cussing, kids. Cussing. Sorry about that.
Get back.
I forgot to bleep.
No.
He's getting in somebody's face.
We're good.
All cops are bastards in the name of Jesus. Amen.
That must have been an Antifa saying that. That's hate speech. According to SPLC or ADL. Look at these evil Antifa people. Talk tough, guy. Talk tougher. They just spray bear spray or something at unarmed people. Knocking down speakers. Destroying equipment. Hands up, don't persecute. Look, a lot of just normal people. Family people.
Go.
There's some young people there, like young conservative people, I would say, Christians. Bring out the water cannons. Yeah, and the dogs, Lisa. I would love to see some dogs to deal with the police dogs to handle the Antifa. These are not Christians, Hake. Only an anti-Christian hates Christ this much, says Go Leche. Of course, I'm like changing the words around. I'm misquoting Go Leche, but paraphrasing. Yeah, I think you're correct, probably, Go Leche. Atheistic people. And then they said, all ACAB, all cops are, and they said, bastards. In Jesus' name. But he doesn't believe in Jesus. Defund women, says Evgeny Crosby. What's that coming from? Defund single mothers? They are definitely funded. The ADL backs Antifa, alleges Odin's sire. And you know what? I suspect that you are correct on that. They said, because ACAB is also put out by, you know, there's some whites who are pro-white, but they don't like the cops because a lot of the cops are, you know, they support the attack on whites, on Christians, on men. They are basically agents of the state, so-called, right? Or of the corrupt government. And they follow orders, even corrupt orders. So that a lot of people, it's a view that a lot of people hold about cops. And in some cases, it's a fact. And so there are right-wingers, supposedly, or at least pro-white people, white advocates, who put out that ACAB thing. I've never seen it before. I've never seen it. Even among the people that I know of who are into that white thing, and they have strong criticisms of the police, I've never seen them say ACAB. And so ADL qualifies the ACAB, all cops are bastards, as a, this is a hate symbol. This is a hate term. I've shown you this like a few weeks back, I want to say. You have to use judgment because some non-racists, as in Antifa, which if racism were to exist, it would be the people who are anti-racist. Because Antifa are anti-racist, and so they judge the whites, and they judge the blacks who don't hate whites enough. And they judge the POCs who do not, the people of color, Hispanics and others. Hake watched Seventh Heaven as a teen. That's where he heard of Pearl Jam. That's not true. I did not really watch that show, although that one girl was kind of pretty. And I didn't really watch it, and I didn't hear of Pearl Jam on it. And I would have been too embarrassed to watch Seventh Heaven. And I didn't hear of Pearl Jam there. I heard it from my friend who played that one, Oh, Where Could My Baby Be? Anyway, I got sidetracked. I get distracted by the chat very easily. I only saw Baked Alaska saying all cops are something, says Odin Sire. I wouldn't be surprised if he might say that. He used to support Black Lives Matter, I hear. He used to work for BuzzFeed. He's been kind of all over the place. Baked Alaska. Nice guy. Misguided at times. Hake, dang Hake, you got real defensive over that comment, says Skipper. Well, yeah, because Seventh Heaven was kind of hokey, and, give me a break. Yeah, it's basically like accusing me of watching Dawson's Creek. Exactly, Credit Solutionist. Man, Hake, we are not your friends, says Joe Roberts. I know. Hake seems more like a Highway to Heaven kind of guy. Thank you, Malkuth X. Yeah, that's more like it. Highway to Heaven, wasn't that guy from Little House on the Prairie? I think it was. That Pearl Jam cover is the worst song ever. So anyway, let me show you. I lost track of the point that I was telling, but basically Antifa is evil, right? We all know this. Here is a woman who was there recounting what happened as she and another woman are tending to a man who says that he's a pastor who apparently got something in his eye, like pepper spray or something, like maybe even debris in his eye. And by the way, Andy Ngo says that Antifa not only toppled, as we saw in the video, the speakers that were up on stands for this event, this Christian-friendly event, or this Christian event, they also threw the sound equipment into the water, into the river, whatever that thing is. Antifa attacks Christians, and that's according to their own tweets, actually. Antifa's own tweets, because Andy Ngo is an Antifa expert. According to one of the militant Antifa members who witnessed the violent direct action is a buzzword from these communists. Communists hate America and hate everybody. Some of them pretend that they're Christians, they're not. They're phonies. Direct action is a buzzword used by that guy who supposedly waved on the driver who drove into the crowd over in Charlottesville. That Antifa professor. He's all direct action. touting that direct action, violent direct action. Antifa threw the Christians group's sound equipment into the Willamette River. Attendees included children. They were hit with projectiles and pepper spray. But I wouldn't have advised that these guys really talk with them, because that just provokes them more. Like, you don't engage these people. As much as you can avoid it, you don't engage them. Right? Melissa Claudio Lewis, Claudio Report, an Antifa member, tweeted, it did not work out for fashion friends. Fascist short for fascists, right? They call anybody who's pro-America a fascist. They hate America. They call America a fascist country, right? So they're anti-American is really what they are. Let's just say their equipment malfunctioned in the river. Melissa Claudio Lewis said, welcome to Portland. You won't like it here, pastor, and then devil horns. Because they were going to do waterfront Saturday, August 7th in noon. According to this Antifa account, after assaulting the attendees in Portland at the Portland Family Christian Prayer event, they stole food and water, says Andy No. Antifa mafioso, Eye of Soros 1, tweeted, remember the Spanish Civil War when the anarchists expropriation wealth from fascist churches and gave it to the poor? Well, today anarchists in Portland expropriated sandwiches and water from the fascist hate preachers and gave them to the houseless. And this was tweeted on Saturday. They tweeted it on Saturday. Phony people. False compassion. Wolves in sheep's clothing. Actually, they're wolves in wolves' clothing. And so listen to this woman and contrast it with something some fake Christian preacher says. This is a woman's account of what happened, according to her, talking with a reporter who was there asking her questions. Listen to this. Yeah, B.
Can you tell us what happened?
So we were about to have a worship event. And Antifa just rolled in like an angry mob, started throwing flash bombs at everybody, macing everybody, rotten eggs at everybody, black paint. They threw a flash bomb into a group of kids that were out there, from like 4 months old to like 10. Yeah, they were ruthless.
Unbelievable. And this is a pastor?
Yeah, I'm a pastor also.
Maybe they threw an egg into his eye.
Walked up to ask them to stop throwing things at the children, because there's kids down there. I mean, they're toddlers.
Yeah.
And they sprayed me too, obviously. So, anyhow.
Too nice. Too nice. Ridiculous, huh? Well, this is what this guy says in response. He's quote tweeting Andy No. Andy No being a leftist sort of. Center left, I would say. He's like openly, never mind, I don't want to get into that. But Andy No, independent journalist, right? Well, this Reverend Dr. Chuck Currie, who might have talked to Jesse Lee Peterson, or else he might have refused to talk to Jesse Lee Peterson. I'm not sure. I totally recognize the name. Oh yeah, sure enough. 11 years ago, January 27th, 2010. Apparently, like, over the course of the decades that Jesse Lee Peterson has had his radio show, different producers have independently invited this so-called Reverend Dr. Chuck Currie onto the Jesse Lee Peterson show, and the coward wrote a whole blog post 10 years ago, and he's repeatedly tweeted it out every time somebody forgets and asks him. We don't keep track of who we've invited all the time, right? Every producer doesn't know what every producer has invited over the decades. Why I won't do the Reverend Jesse Lee Peterson show, this Chuck Currie, Reverend Dr. Chuck Currie, he's supposedly white. Let me show you a screenshot of his website. I'll put it in the folder. But it was posted Wednesday, January 27th, 2010. He said, a booker for the Jesse Lee Peterson show called yesterday afternoon and asked if I would be a guest on the program this week to talk about my pro-choice views, views consistent with official positions taken by the General Synod of the United Church of Christ, most mainland Christian denominations, and many other Christian Americans, including Roman Catholics. So he's pro-abortion, pro-killing the baby, right? I've never heard of Reverend Peterson before, and the booker was vague when I asked about Reverend Peterson's views, but finally offered that he would likely disagree with my stance that he was fair and that he was a fair and honest radio talk show host who liked to hear various points of view. I agreed to be on the show. That was until I looked up his record. And here's the record from Jesse Lee Peterson. Jesse Lee Peterson has said, Barack Obama hates white people, especially white men. Fact. It turns out that Reverend Peterson is a radical religious extremist. And Jesse Lee Peterson quote, I was born a Democrat, but I had no values. It was anything goes. Whatever you want to do, that came from black leadership. But I finally started to examine it for myself, and I realized the Democrat platform was anti-God, anti-values, anti-American platform. His views go way beyond offensive, says Reverend Chuck Currie. Oh, let me drag this into the folder so you can see it. I'll put it into that Antifa attacks Christians thing. Oh, I put it in there. It's just screenshot. Well, at least you can see the pictures of this guy. You see the top of the article. When Hurricane Katrina hit, then President Bush failed to get aid to New Orleans quickly, Reverend Peterson said, I stated that if whites were just to leave the United States and let blacks run the country, they would turn America into a ghetto within 10 years. I gave blacks too much credit. It took a mere 3 days for blacks to turn the Superdome and the convention center into ghettos, rampant with theft, rape, and murder. All facts, all truth from JLP. This guy lies and falsely calls Jesse Lee Peterson himself an African-American, which is not what Jesse Lee Peterson is. He's an American. What he is not is a speaker of the truth. can't name one thing that he said wasn't true. He only gave factual quotes. And so this morning I wrote Reverend Peterson's booker and producer and told them, thank you for the invitation. Before you called, I had not heard of the Reverend Jesse Lee Peterson. However, after reviewing his record last night, it is clear that he is a radical extremist and that my appearance on his show could only serve to offer him legitimacy. His hate-filled rhetoric toward people of different faiths and political views are irresponsible and should have no place in American discourse. So this is a communist. This guy doesn't believe in the freedom of speech. Therefore, I decline the interview request. He also doesn't believe in the truth. I certainly have no problem appearing on conservative religious programs. I did so just this week to discuss economic issues. But Reverend Peterson is no conservative. His record of promoting hate and division is far outside the bounds of common decency. So this is the type of person that this Frank? Chuck Currie is. He shouldn't even be on the air, this guy says. No surprise that he has been a regular on Fox News. Also, I'll mention, nowhere in his bio does it mention which denomination Reverend Peterson is ordained in or where he earned his theological degree. So this man believes in men. He doesn't believe in God. He believes in degrees, not God. The omission leaves one to question his credentials. So that's Chuck Currie. That's just a taste of what Chuck Currie is. So keep that in mind. I almost choked. Keep that in mind when you read this. Reverend Dr. Chuck Currie, he quote tweets Andy Ngo here. Christian minister in Portland here. This was no family Christian prayer event. It was a far-right political rally organized by a failed MAGA congressional candidate from California. Just assume everything Andy Ngo tweets is made up. So that's what this liar says. He calls everybody far right who's basically pro-America and Christian. Crazy. He could have just declined. He didn't have to write a novel, says Stinger GT2. No, he's a coward, so he has to justify his cowardice. He's an insecure coward, and he's fat. Anyway, he also says Jesus was a refugee. What a total phony. Don't choke, Hake. Anyway. So should Jesus have stayed away from sinners' homes because they were extremists? Because he would have given them legitimacy? Cowards come up with all kinds of excuses to avoid being challenged, says Bible go-to guy in a super chat. Indeed. Indeed. I just saw some crazy news. Wow. They took down Andrew Cuomo. Shout out to Big Bump for the tip. They took down Andrew Cuomo for being, even though he's not a man, he resembles a man just slightly. And so because he is physically speaking a man, they took him down. That's enough man for you, New York. You can't have a man. You can't have a man in office. We need a weakling. Like, Andrew Cuomo looks like a man. He has, like, a strong-looking face, almost. Even though he is Italian. And we all know those Italians. Man, they can be, pretty female-minded. Female-oriented, right? But they took him down for being a man. They have this fake sexual harassment scandal. Not because he killed the, Trump voters. The elderly Trump voters. Our beautiful elderly Trump voters in the, nursing homes. No. Harassed women. Which is such a lie. Zero evidence. And so it's he's outlived his usefulness. I saw that, credit solutionist. I can't repeat that. He was taken down for being, anyway. I wonder if they'll do the same to Joe Biden one day. Anyway, what a shame. Terrible shame. Thoughts and prayers for Andrew Cuomo. Wow, effective in 14 days, according to Fox News. What a mess. Not zero evidence, but okay, Hake. Well, what, John Jones? What? What evidence do they have? He put out pictures of himself kissing people. What's the evidence? But anyway, let me know. If you know of evidence against Cuomo, against... Anyway, I don't even care. Should you care? It's between them. An honest woman would address him privately and not go out there with the hashtag MeToo madness. MeToo got him? Not that? Yeah. Terrible. So, yes, between Andy No, whom I don't know much, and this so-called Christian pastor, Reverend Dr. Chuck Currie, a believer in credentials, not in God, Reverend Chuck Currie. He calls himself a Christian minister in Portland, which is, he's nothing of the sort. And it was a family Christian prayer event. If there are kids there, toddlers, and there's older people, Gen X and older, and then there's some younger people. There's some younger people who look like they're capable of defending themselves. But they didn't come armed. At least I didn't see any arms. Arms as in, like, weapons. Even self-defense weapons. I think I'll go with Andy No on this one. I think I'll believe Andy No before I believe Chuck Currie on anything. Total phony. Hey, Hank, you're so immature, says Lou Will. You always say that. It's been, oh my gosh, we are at almost 40 after and I have not taken a call yet, guys. Yeah, I know, that's true. That's true. Miklo El Chicano says something about Andy No that is true, that he says about himself. I don't like to repeat it, but he's not exactly morally straight. He's not even morally straight. What a shame. What a shame. Stewart in Massachusetts, on the line. Let me finally get to him. You can call in 888-775-3773. Stewart, thank you for holding. What's up?
Not much. How's it going today?
Going well. How are you?
Good. I was just doing some gardening while I was waiting.
Nice. Right on.
Yeah. Calms the savage soul. But I feel like Bond is, I just feel like there's conflicting information. I'm a person, I like to see logic across the board, and if something contradicts, I like to kind of call it out.
Okay.
And the contradiction. Okay, the contradiction, and I don't know if you can. I mean, you know, I know this is. I know Bond is Jesse's organization, or yeah.
Right. This is the Hake Report. But I'll do my best. Go for it.
And I just want you to do your best. That's all. I feel like there's conflicting information, calling men beta, for not controlling their wives, when men are not allowed to do that anymore by society, and to tell men, if a woman is educated, don't marry her. Well, that's almost all women. Even if a woman has gone to high school, a lot of the education starts. A lot of the, you know, they see women in places of authority way before college. It's not just most of my education was high school.
I'm pretty sure Jesse means college. He's not talking about women finishing high school. But I see your point that the high school is a corrupting aspect of it as well.
Oh, it totally is. Yeah. They learn all that feminism and everything started at, like, okay, even when I was in high school in the late 80s, I went to high school 84 to 89. I know it was a long time ago.
Wow, how did you go to high school from 84 to 89? The 6-year plan?
What is it? 80, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, or whatever. It's late.
I went 95 to 99.
Yes, right. Okay. So 85. So I'll say 85 to 89.
Okay.
So my point being is, yeah, is that the schools were ruined then. Okay.
Yeah.
They were ruined then. I was coming home and I've read about it, and I read how the policies in the schools are purposely.
You might have eighth grade might have been included in high school for where you went to school. So I could be, you could be correct.
No. It was 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th. Just I don't remember the exact years, but because it's 85, 86. Like, you start in September of 85 and then go into 86 or whatever. But so I miscalculated. But so anyway, basically. You know, I've read up about this from a woman. I won't mention her name because we're not allowed to name drop unless you want me to. She's been on the Alex Jones show before. Oh, I just dropped the name. But anyway,
who's interviewed Jesse Lee Peterson before?
When you're restricted as far as rules, it's hard to even communicate all this stuff because there's so much to communicate. But I was rebelling. I was a good kid. I wasn't a bully. Didn't do drugs. Didn't drink. Didn't smoke cigarettes. Didn't do almost anything. And the high school outsmarted me. I was only a kid, and got me to rebel against them. And so I would get in trouble and be in detention all the time, to the point where, like I was so disrespectful. To the point where when the principal talked to me, when he got done talking, I'd be like, are you done yet? And he'd be like, yeah. And I'd be like, okay, well, good, because I'm not listening to one word that I said. I would say this right to his face. Not one word that comes out of your mouth matters to me.
Nice.
That's what I would literally say to my
well,
principal.
Not nice, but interesting. Yeah.
Right. Exactly. But but I found out later from this lady that they do this on purpose. We're way off topic, but they get the men. They use authoritarianism in the schools. And I'll give you an example. One person did something wrong, so everybody's in trouble. That's authoritarianism.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? One person broke the rule, so now we got to make this new rule.
Sometimes authoritarianism is a good thing.
Sometimes, I guess, but what that does is a young alpha leadership type male who's moral will instinctively rebel against authoritarianism.
True.
And they
sometimes
know that. So,
yeah.
So my point is you can't. I mean, I refuse to call men beta, and it's almost like taunting them. You know what I mean? In a society where they're not the authority, the police are the authorities now. Go ask any judge. You are not the king. Anybody who says they're the king of their castle, you either A, you found like the 0.001% girl that will allow you to be the king of your castle, or B, you're delusional. You're delusional because you are the police. You know, and women are emotional. You can't say, well, if you were an alpha male, your wife wouldn't call the cops. Well, then that contradicts everything that we're saying about women being emotional and not rational and logical. So you can be an alpha male, and all the girl has to do is call the police, and the police will quickly show up and let you know that you are not in control of your home.
Yeah, I know.
The quote authorities are, and they literally use that term authorities now to see we're the authorities, not the police. That men have to understand that we're the authorities, and we only created a legitimate job for the police because we can't be. We got because the average person has things to do. You can't be running around trying to solve crimes all day. So we created a job, and we didn't used to just throw everybody in jail and prison. See, conservatives don't understand the history of this country anymore. When you got in trouble, we didn't used to have prisons.
Hold on, you're filling up my mind. Go back to your point.
Okay, I'm just saying. My point is that it's taunting to call men beta in a day and age where A, most women won't let a man. Won't allow a man to be the alpha or the king of the castle.
And I don't like that. I don't like that term of a woman letting the man be that. Be like that.
Yeah, well, that's what they're supposed to do.
No, it's not, man.
They're supposed to submit. They're supposed to submit,
but that doesn't mean that they're letting the man lead. That's not the right wording, man.
Well, he's supposed to. Okay, well, whatever. How would you word it then?
I don't know, but if the man is leading. The woman doesn't have a choice either to be in this. Are you kidding?
Plenty of marriages break up when the guy says, "All right, we're moving to the city."
That's fine. Then they break up.
Right. So that would be a case where the man's leading, and then if he tries to in any
the
way,
man's, but the man's leading either way. She either leaves or she stays. He's leading
okay,
either
so
way.
Now, and this brings up another part of my point.
All
right. It's child abuse. It's child abuse to let these women run off with the kids. And that's what I'm hearing, too, is don't do anything. There's nothing you can do about it. First of all, you're...
It's child abuse on whose part? On whose part?
You're spitting. You're... Huh?
Wait, hold on. Let me clarify.
Anybody who allows a woman to run off with the kids and alienate the father, even if he gets shared custody and only sees the kid for
Are you accusing a man of child abuse for not wasting his money in courts on a losing battle to
beyond court. We don't go to court.
I'm talking about answer my question. Hold on, Stewart.
Is it child abuse for a man? Yes.
Hold on, man. I haven't finished my question.
Okay, go ahead.
Is it child abuse for a man to give up his child once the woman tries to take the child away? Is it child abuse on the part of the man to do that?
Yes.
You're wrong about that. The person abusing the child is the woman. It's not the man.
Right.
So how are you accusing the man of child abuse?
Because you are. What is that when you're partner to a crime but you didn't commit the crime?
An accomplice. Doesn't make him accomplice.
You are. It's not accomplice. There's another word for
neglect?
It. It's not neglect. It's. I forget.
You're talking
the word
out of
now.
Now you're talking out of both sides of your mouth. You're contradicting yourself.
I'm not.
Yeah,
no,
you are. You're
no,
slapping the man for something the woman's doing.
No, you're slapping. Bond is slapping the man.
No, you're the. You're just slapping the man.
Men have no control.
You accused him of
men
child abuse.
Men have no control. You're saying for men not to do anything.
Right.
About it, and to let the woman run off with the kid.
It's not let. She's already gone.
It's abuse.
It's not let.
You are.
It's already gone. How are you?
The state.
Wait,
Stewart. The state is abusing the kids.
Stewart.
The state is abusing the kids.
I know that.
Well, let me make one point.
No, let me ask you the point. No, let me ask you the question because you're talking out of both sides of your mouth.
No, I'm not.
On one side, you're saying, hold on, man. Hold on.
Alienation of a parent is child abuse. No, I'm not. I don't. Alienation of a parent is child abuse.
I know that, but it's not the father's fault for letting the kid go.
It's all the men's fault. It's all the men's fault. That's where men are at fault.
So you're talking out of both sides of your mouth. On one hand, it's not the you need to be slept. On one side, it's not the man's fault because he was set up to be not able to be a man and independent from childhood.
Okay, I understand.
That's you saying
that.
And then on the other hand, it's man's fault for the woman destroying the kids with the state's help.
All right. I understand. No, I'm not saying the man's abusing the kid. The woman is abusing the kid.
You said the man is abusing the kid. You said the man is guilty of child abuse.
Well, then I misspoke. But take
you did not misspeak. I clearly asked you.
Yes, I did.
I clearly asked you.
No.
Is it wrong
you're getting frustrated. You're getting emotional.
No, you're the one who's emotional. Don't be playing that game.
I'm smiling.
You're smiling, but you're
game.
Out of your mind.
Okay, so either way, no, I'm not out of my mind.
Serial killers smile.
See, this is what you see. Now you're accusing a white male of who is hated by society, and now you're saying, "Oh, I'm out of it." See, this is more.
You're accusing a white. I'm a white male too. You're accusing me.
No. I'm telling you, society is abusing the kids. The courts are abusing the kids. The police are abusing the kids. And the father and the fathers have no say. But if all the men would stand together against all of this, and I mean, use their Bill of Rights and their Second Amendment to make sure.
No,
that the,
okay,
the,
you're Fed posting now, Stewart. You're out of your mind, man.
What's wrong with you? That's what our founders wanted. That's what our founders wanted.
But you don't even know what you're talking about. Your spirit's
George
evil.
George Washington was out of his mind. No,
you
I'm
are out of your mind.
No,
you
don't.
You're
like
not George Washington.
No, yeah.
You are. Are you George Washington?
George Washington would be.
George Washington.
You would call George Washington names.
You have no clue what I would call George Washington. You are not George Washington, Stewart.
Most people did. Most people.
I'm not most people. I'm not most people.
Our founders. Our founders did not mean for.
Your spirit is evil. Beta. Being a beta is a spiritual issue.
I'm a good man.
No, you are not a good man.
I hope. Oh yes, I am.
No man
I'm a
is
very good.
Good
man.
Are you a Christian?
So now you're gonna quote the Bible.
Are you a Christian?
I'm a Christian. Yes, I love.
Then how
Jesus
are you saying that you are a good man?
Because I love Jesus and I don't sin anymore.
That doesn't make you good.
Yeah. Well, it makes me. I'm going to heaven.
You don't know that.
I'm going to heaven. Says if I believe.
You
in
don't
Jesus
know
and
that,
give my
and
life
you are not
him.
A good man. You claim that you are a good man. Anyway.
I have no criminal record, and I'm not guilty until
proven innocent.
You have the standards
of black people.
Our entire country is based on that, Hake.
No,
that's
ridiculous.
Yeah, you're doing what a judge does. You're trying to make an innocent man with no criminal record look like he's out of his mind. That's what the leftists do. You're doing what the leftists do right now.
No, you're falling into the leftist trap.
I'm for men. No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I don't get along with either. I don't get along with either.
But you fell into the leftist trap.
I'm an independent. I'm a constitutionalist. And by the Constitution, men can stand up against this.
You are.
We have the choice. Our founders did not want us to be victimized.
Be honest.
And to not.
Be honest.
I'm being honest.
Be honest. Are you angry?
I'm speaking. No.
Yeah, you are.
No, I'm not. No.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm a little frustrated.
See,
little
that's
frustrated
anger.
Because.
Frustration
no,
is anger.
No.
Yes, it is. Be a man.
I am a man.
No, you're not.
I am a man.
You're
yes,
not.
Yes, I am. I'm a man. I work.
You
pay,
just.
Pay for all.
You're dancing
I,
around
I own,
the fact
I
that
own
you're angry.
My own home. I own my own home. I've worked my entire adult life.
You sound
I'm
like a black.
Absolutely a man. I'm absolutely
you
a man.
You sound like
no,
a black.
I'm not black. I am a
you
white.
Sound like a black.
Constitutional.
Can I tell you why you sound like a black?
You sound it. And I'll tell you why you sound anti-constitutional.
Okay, go ahead, but let me first tell you.
Because for men to let the state and the women rule over them is to spit in the face of 14-year-olds that pushed cannons through the snow till their feet fell off so that men wouldn't have to live like this. And you can ask anybody in my family.
Okay, you can drop the drama.
You can ask.
All right, you can drop the drama.
So the Constitution
let me tell you why you
drama.
Sound.
So you
Stewart.
Hate America then,
Stewart.
So you hate America and freedom.
Are you going to let
answer
me?
My question.
Are you going? Are you?
To answer my question. Do you?
I'm
going to
put you on hold if you don't calm down.
I'm not uncalm. I'm very
yes, you
calm.
Are not calm.
I'm trying to talk over you because you keep accusing me and calling me names instead of stating facts.
Let me tell you why
so
I'm.
Me
Stewart.
Trying to talk over you is not me being angry, Hake.
You are a
you
psycho.
You can't have it that way. No, I'm not a psycho. I have no criminal record. I have no criminal
Lots
record.
Lots of psychos have no criminal
I'm
record.
I'm a Boy Scout. I'm a Boy Scout compared to most men.
Let me
what
explain.
What are you talking about?
Let me explain.
If you go around my town, all right, there are bad
up.
Guys.
I'm going to hang up if you don't be quiet.
Wait. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
Stewart, take a
go
breath.
Ahead.
Take a breath.
I am. You take a breath, too. Go ahead.
So.
I just want an answer to my question.
I hung up on him. He doesn't shut up. This is why I called Stewart like a black. Because so many blacks have called in to the Jesse Lee Peterson show or talked on some TV show or gone on stuff and they will say, my son was a good man or I've been a good man, no criminal record, never been to jail, graduated from college. I'm a Boy Scout compared to most people. I'm not a psycho. I've never committed any... not that I've never committed any crimes. I don't have a criminal record. And anyway. So that's why. That's why you sound like a black man. But I appreciate the call. I do appreciate it, man. But you just can't control yourself. And last point to you, sir, if you're listening. Hopefully you're listening. To dance around the fact that you're angry and say, I'm not angry, I'm a little frustrated. That's the same thing. Idiot. You sound like Joe from Phoenix, man. So anyway. I'm sure he got burned from the January 6th thing, says Super Dave. Yeah, a lot of people are very frustrated at what's going on. And it makes you fall into that trap. And it makes you go to the Second Amendment before it's time for the Second Amendment. Oh, man. Was he Fed posting? He's either insanely dogmatic or he's a Fed, says Dan East. Yeah. A pure case of purity spiraling. Yeah. This guy's panting like a neurotic dog out of breath and will not ever shut his yapper, says Ragnar 0321. Off the rails. Literally screaming that he's not angry, says Cheesehead 69. Yeah. Calling a man a beta or calling a woman a slut or Jesus calling somebody a hypocrite or a brood of vipers or whatever is proof that name calling is very effective when it's accurate, says Bible go-to guy in a super chat. Oh my gosh. Tip from Big Bump sharing a tweet from Breaking 911. Great outlet. I will get to more of your calls, guys. Thank you for your call, man. I had to hang up because it was dragging too much and you couldn't calm down. But if you do calm down ever again, like you are welcome to call again another day. Once a day, guys. Only one call per day, per show. New York, Breaking 911 reports, Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul, a 62-year-old so-called Democrat, and former member of Congress from the Buffalo area, will become the state's 57th governor and the first woman to hold the post. Kathy Hochul, Hochul, H-O-C-H-U-L. I gotta get a picture of this woman. Let me see if I can just drag this into the folder. Directly. Direct action. Nonviolent direct action. Anti-Antifa action. IMG_0359 is the name of this. You can just show this picture of this woman. We're going to go to break, guys, but look at this woman who's Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul, or Hochul. She's who picked this woman to be Lieutenant Governor? She's going to become the so-called governor, 57th governor of the state of New York. Kathy Hochul. Hochul? How do you pronounce this? What a disgrace. And honestly, like, that's a nice picture of her. She looks pretty crazy nowadays. Hochul, okay. Terrible. A lawyer, which means she's a liar. What a disgrace. Evil woman, no doubt. The male has been replaced. First caller is Merle 2.0, says single mom doing her best. Calls, please, says single mom doing her best. Yeah, all right. The lines are full, guys. I will get to your calls. But first, oh my gosh, we have another like 5-minute track from Stavesacre. Won't this be nice, though? And I actually really like this song. It's called Gold and Silver. It's from their 1999 album, Speakeasy. Stavesacre. Gold and Silver. Enjoy, guys, and I'll be right back for the rest of Hour 2. More calls and clips and fun stuff. Hang tight.
Sometimes we have to hide.
Isn't this nice? Nice, Hake. Real nice, says Rickley. Thank you, man. How about Soundgarden? This sounds safe. Whoa. Not too bad, right? Not too bad. That was Stavesacre, Gold and Silver. They did another version of that that they put out as like a free MP3. Remember those back in the day? After 9/11 hit. Isn't that a nice song for the 9/11 sadness? Not that I was necessarily that sad. I lived in California. I couldn't really emotionally relate to it. Although I knew New Yorkers, and every time I bring it up to them, to this day, they tear up over 9/11, 2001.
To this day!
Yep. Males. Grown adult males. So. Wasn't that bad, says John Jones. Thank you, man. So, guys. Let me, before I get back to calls, and shout out to that caller. I actually really enjoyed that call. Let me play another clip I wanted to share with you. This interesting clip. From, let's see. Speaking of anger. Clip 11. I came across this. Oh, can you show me? Oh, you're showing me, but it's not the live me. I want to play clip 11. I got this from Telegram. Shout out to... I think it's the Crypto Report on Telegram. I probably also saw it on Real Vincent James Telegram. You know these people who've, white Americans who've been silenced for being Christian and being pro-America, not sufficiently hating white people. So they get censored and they have to go to Telegram, which I hear is a Russian app. It's ridiculous. In America, I thought this was America. This is not America? You don't have the freedom of speech? It kind of reminds me of my prior caller. Was that MGTOW Misfit? I'm curious. Was that MGTOW Misfit who called in? He enjoyed it even though he called you a psycho and hung up on you, says Emperor of Cats. Yeah, I did enjoy it. And he is a psycho. Well, he did sound like one anyway. And I did hang up on him because he wouldn't shut up. And I talked to him for like 15 minutes at least. Maybe more. Anyway, I saw this. This is a clip from CNN. Going around. It's from a while ago, actually. It's from weeks back when, remember those Capitol police officers? One guy said, oh, this woman called me a N-word. Only he didn't say N-word. He said the full-blown hard R, N-I-G-G-E-R word. Somebody said, oh, yeah, and then they surrounded me and said, oh, this N-word voted for Joe Biden. N-word! Because he opened up his mouth. And by the way, that black so-called Capitol police officer or whatever he was, he admitted, or it came out, that he had previously gone online. What did he do? Oh, his name was Harry Dunn. According to Newsmax, they tweeted out some days ago, weeks ago maybe, Capitol Police Officer Harry Dunn, the guy who said, accused Trump supporters of calling him the N-word, yeah, right, I wish, who testified at the House Select Committee investigating the so-called January 6th incidents at the U.S. Capitol, has an online history of criticizing, meaning smearing, former President Donald J. Trump and conservative figures. Tweets show Capitol Officer Dunn as critical of Trump praising BLM protests. Black Lives Matter. Scum of the earth. Talk about a traitor. To his own, whatever thing. Hake should have supported what that guy was saying, but needs controversies for his show. Loser, Hake. What? I supported what he's saying until he started talking about, oh, we need to stand up. We have the Second Amendment. That's all we have. No, you have the spirit, but he has no power in his spirit. He has only anger. And frustration. Frustration is anger, buddy. I'm referring to that caller. People are still sour grapes about my call. Maybe you guys should calm down with all caps. Here is Don Lemon. You know, the gay black guy who is a Trump derangement syndrome sufferer to the major degree. Just beside himself. Insane. Don Lemon of CNN. radical homosexual, radical Black Lives Matter supporter, evil, Trump hater, America hater. He played an uncensored voicemail, and so I censored it because I am a family-friendly, child-friendly show. This is a family-friendly, child-friendly show. Did you know that? And so I censored it, but he didn't censor it. And he's interviewing this guy, this other Capitol Police officer, Michael Fanone, who has this long beard. He's like a slim, supposedly or whatever, white, supposedly, guy named Michael Fanone, who also testified and bashed Trump supporters and pretended this Capitol mostly peaceful protest was some type of horrific event. It was not good, where it got out of control. It was not good there was bad behavior on many sides. There were cops who did wrong. There were perhaps even actual Trump supporters who did wrong. There was a Black Lives Matter agitator who was there too. Light-skinned black radical. Grifter. But listen to this clip. It's about a minute and a half long. They're gonna play this voicemail that this hate voicemail that this Capitol Police officer supposedly received. And maybe it's his buddy who just did this to him. And it's amazing how they keep a straight face. But listen to this clip. 11. It's from CNN.
It includes some incredibly offensive language, but we think people need to hear the kind of attacks that these officers are facing right now just for telling the truth about January 6th. Play it.
Yeah, this is from Michael Fanone, Metropolitan Police Officer. You're on trial right now. Lying and you want an Emmy, an Oscar? What are you trying to go for here? You're so full of shit, you little You're a little man. I can slap you up the side of your head with a backhand and knock you out, you little You're a punk You're a lying How about all that scummy black scum for 2 years, destroying our cities and burning them and stealing all that shit out of the stores and everything? How about that, and assaulting cops and killing people? How about that, you That was shit on the goddamn Capitol. I wish they would have killed all you scumbags, because you people are scum. They the election from Trump, and you know that, you scumbag. And you too bad they didn't beat the shit out of you more. You're a piece of shit. You're a little you scumbag.
Wow.
It was important for you. You did not want us to censor that. What do you say to that? What do you want people to know? And that idiot.
I mean, I remember like my first reaction immediately after listening to that phone call, which I actually received while I was testifying in the hearing today. This is what happens to people that tell the truth in Trump's America.
That simple.
That simple.
It doesn't bother you. It doesn't hurt you.
Isn't that crazy? What happened to him? I don't know what happened to him. Nothing happened to him. He got rewarded. He got a CNN interview. He got to speak in Congress, acting like he's important. And he got an entertaining voicemail that may or may not be real. I don't know. It was pretty honest. Maybe there was some anger there. Maybe some frustration. The caller was his son, says Matt Godson. Man Godson. Yeah, who knows? But it was, like, hard to picture these people actually taking that seriously. Or acting like that's a horrific thing to receive. We all get nasty voicemails and nasty threats and everything. Anybody who's a public figure who stands up either for good or for evil is going to get crazy threats. And I didn't even really hear a threat, although he did wish ill upon the guy, at least with his words. I don't know if he meant it, right? He's like, oh, I would slap you upside the head and knock you out. But and he said worse than that. He said worse than that. But he said something about wishing actually evil to befall him, right? You don't wish evil on a person. But he pretty much told the truth. It sounded real. It sounded real. America first. Well, he said AF. I don't know if he meant real America first. America first would not go to evil, but it would express similar thoughts is what that guy expressed. But not every thought would be some of those thoughts I would disavow, right? Yes, I think I will open the treasure chest over there on DLive in about 40 minutes, okay? I shall open the treasure chest on DLive in about 40 minutes. We have quite a treasure chest built up over there on DLive. Wow, I have actually some balance. It's odd, I guess, because a lot of you guys are subscribers, even though you can't give any lemons or diamonds or ice cream or ninjaginis or even ninjets on the Hake Report. It's PG-13 compared to the voicemail I get from my ex-wife, says red-pilled Rican. Exactly. Give me a break. What happened to him? This is what happens to people. And they pretend that they tell the truth. Tell the truth in Donald Trump's America. Is that a real accent that this Michael Fanone guy has? He talks like he has a southern accent. Why did he grow up? Why are you gay? Why did he grow up to think like such a female? Are we that subverted? Are we that subverted? That even Southerners are losing their minds. Maybe so. CNN called it a horrific voicemail. Yeah, that's true. Oh, man. Yeah, he didn't tell the truth. There's zero truth that this guy told. Anyway, I have other fun clips for you guys. But the lines are full, and I don't want to go another 40 minutes without getting to another call. So, let me get to Victor in Texas regarding the alleged party switch. Haven't heard from Victor in a while. Victor, thank you for holding, man, forever. How are you doing?
First of all, Hank, I'd like to ask, what does acting black mean?
Oh, are you referring to my call with the MGTOW? Is it MGTOW Misfit? The guy who called into my show who was like, oh, men are not allowed to be men?
I didn't hear him say that.
Oh, yeah, that's what his point was, that men are not allowed to be men. And he's right about that. He was right about almost everything he said, but he's going a little off the deep end.
So he said men are supposed to be girls.
Yeah, he said that they make men into being girls.
Okay.
Yeah. So what I said about acting black was, you know how a lot of blacks... Are you on a speakerphone? I'm hearing weird feedback and you're sounding kind of quiet.
No, I'm not on speakerphone.
Okay, so let me explain what I mean by acting like he sounds black. I don't know if you do this, but there are blacks out there who will say, and it's so shallow, my son never been to jail, he's graduated college, he's a good, upstanding young man. But
what's wrong with saying that?
Because those are shallow things. Life is spiritual. It's not those physical, not going outside, out of bounds type of things. Those are very low standards. That's not moral standards. And this man says that he's a Christian and he doesn't sin, but yet he's getting frustrated. So and he doesn't admit that frustration is anger, so he's dancing around the truth.
Fine, if it's all spiritual, then why did you criticize George Floyd by calling him an unemployed drug addict every single time?
That's Jesse Lee Peterson who does that, but
I
fully endorse Jesse Lee Peterson calling him an unemployed drug addict. I don't really call him that, but it was a mess, for sure. What do you mean it's all spiritual? Being an unemployed drug addict shows a lack of spiritual strength.
You said it's all about spiritual, it's not about, like, it's shallow things. So why did you and Jesse keep mentioning that Joe was an unemployed drug addict if it doesn't matter? It's shallow.
That does matter.
Why are you bringing it up?
That's a sign of poor spirit. But just the fact that you're not a drug addict or you have a job, that doesn't mean your spirit's good. It's more than that. It's basically we have higher standards than just... Yes, we should succeed in a worldly way. We should have a job. We should not be on drugs. We should overcome our vices. But those are low standards. That's not righteousness. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
You have to have love and not hate. You have to have patience and wisdom and know when to fight, know when to stand back, know when to do this or that.
where do you get your wisdom from? Because apparently, just you can't read the Bible to seek guidance for. So where do you get your wisdom from?
You can read the Bible and find a little bit of guidance, but the teacher is within. Even the Bible says that Jesus sent the Holy Spirit to be the teacher within and guide you in all things.
And how you get the Holy Spirit, Hank?
Whoa, that's very aggressive. I like that. It's Hake, did you know that? But I like Hank. I like Hank. But it's Hake, H-A-K-E. But I like Hank. You can continue to call me Hank. You have to be born again of God. I don't know, read the Bible.
And how do you know about God?
Most of us do not know anything about God.
You gotta read your Bible.
No, man, that's not gonna teach you God.
Because it seems like with Jesse, anytime someone reads the Bible, hold on, man, the Bible thumper.
Let me explain. Did you know that the Bible says anyone who sins has neither seen God nor known Him. So reading the Bible doesn't mean anything, because there's a whole lot of sinning Christian Bible readers.
That's why you gotta follow the Ten Commandments.
Yeah, but you can't follow them unless you're born again.
And by being born again, you gotta read your Bible.
No, man, not necessarily. I mean, it can help a little bit, maybe. He calls you Hank as an insult.
Okay, so my original question for our couple, I want to ask if there was a party switch.
Oh, okay, yeah. Oh, you know, I liked your first question. That's cool, though. Go ahead with your party switch question.
So, will Democrats and Republicans, will they switch it back? Because in more southern states, I would say there's more discrimination. Not that I'm saying that racism exists, but there's more discrimination.
Repeat that one more time. I was blanking. I was reading the chat, and I tuned you out. I apologize. Say that again.
I said Republican and Democrat. At one point, the Republicans were the one that freed the slaves, but not today. If you go to the southern states, there's more KKK active in the southern states than I would say the northern states. So was there a party switch?
Oh, and you're saying also the southern states are more Republican, and you're saying the KKK is more Republican now?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's more active in the Republican states. So was there a party switch?
I don't know. KKK is like barely existent, if at all. But I know that there are people who are white who are into being white, and I don't see anything inherently wrong with that, except that your identity should be in God.
You don't see anything wrong with being the KKK?
I don't know, because I don't know any KKK members, so I haven't even been able to ask them what they're really about. But from what I understand, the KKK were, you know, back in the day when they first started, what I heard was that they were Southerners who were trying to defend against the oppression from the federal government, because the feds came in and tried to, like, crack the whip and crack down their version of the law. And so they were fighting back.
That's not true.
How do you know? Were you there?
They were fighting. Yes.
You were not there.
They were fighting for blacks, Jews, and homos not to vote. That's what they were fighting for.
I don't think the North wanted blacks, Jews, and homos to vote right after the Civil War, man.
You're right. That Democratic Party didn't. That's what I'm asking. Was there a party switch?
I don't think Democrats or Republicans wanted blacks, Jews, and homos to vote.
Republicans wanted blacks to vote. Republicans are the
Oh yeah. Yeah, after a while they did want the blacks to vote. That's true.
Yeah, and then the welfare got to them, and then blacks went over to the Democratic side. So I'm asking if there was a party switch, because it seems more now Republicans don't really like blacks.
What makes you think that the Republicans don't like blacks?
Well, Hank, I'd like you to ask Jesse to go down to Mississippi. In specifically Money, Mississippi. I like you to go down there, and your experiment shall be there.
Our experience in Republicans supposedly not liking blacks in Mississippi somewhere?
Yes.
But you're talking about the Republicans in general don't seem to like blacks. Why do we have to go somewhere? Why do we have to go to some rural place to find that out?
Since you said that that it's not as active, so go there. If racism don't exist, go there.
But what's your problem? Like, race, do you think that racism exists or not?
No.
Then how come, discrimination? Yeah, discrimination is a basic right of all people to discriminate, right?
Is it good?
Yeah, very often it's good. And sometimes it's not necessarily wise.
Oh, so why did Jesse cry when they kicked him out the gym? He filed a lawsuit.
Right, because we have to use their own laws against them.
Nah.
Yeah.
Beta.
That's not beta. That's alpha.
He's like, they bullied me. They kicked me out.
I know. He's using their words against them.
Jesse, they have a right. Jesse, every business has a right to serve who they want. And they didn't want to serve Jesse. They kicked them out, and Jesse started crying.
He did not cry. You're giving fake news. You're spreading disinformation.
No, it's not disinformation.
Yeah, he did not cry.
It's still on his Twitter page.
He did not cry, though.
He was like, they kicked me out. They bullied me.
Right.
They went in my face.
He's using the female. He's using the female words against them because they fall for the female words. He's mocking them. Like it's just like when he called the woman racist. He turned the tables against them. You're a racist. You can't yell at a black man. He's mocking them with their own fake laws, fake values.
Okay, but he contradicts himself. But
that's not contradicting yourself. That's using these people's fakeness against them.
Because in some interviews, you're like most black Americans are racist towards white people. I thought racism doesn't exist.
He stopped saying that after he realized that racism doesn't exist.
But that interview was 8 years ago.
8 years ago, he didn't realize that racism doesn't exist 8 years ago.
Yes, he did.
When?
Jesse was racism doesn't exist 35 years ago.
No, he did not.
Yes, he did.
No, he didn't. 35 years ago was even before he woke up, dude. Where's your math?
Are you black? Years ago. I mean, 32 years ago. That's
no, but that's not when he found out that racism doesn't exist. He found out that racism is not the problem.
He started bomb 32 years ago.
I know, but he made new discoveries. He made new discoveries over time. There was one church, I will grant you this, there was one church service in 2012 in which he said racism does not exist. But he did not start repeating that until around the time that the Antidote book came out, which was November of 2015. So you're mistaken when you say that, oh, he's contradicting himself. He stopped saying, he realized that blacks aren't racist, they're evil.
All right, Hank.
Yeah.
Back in 1991, did Jesse say blacks are not suffering due to racism, but due to the lack of moral character? Did he not say that?
Matt the American says, this is the Hake Report. Hake caller needs to call JLP in the morning. But I'll indulge you one last question. What were you just asking me?
I said back in 1991.
Yeah.
Right? They just say black Americans are not suffering due to racism, but due to the lack of moral character.
That's correct. That's correct.
Okay.
That doesn't mean that he was thinking that racism doesn't exist way back then.
Wait. So in an interview 8 years ago, he said most black Americans are racist towards white people. So why is he contradicting himself like that?
That's not contradicting himself, man. What the heck? I just explained to you he didn't realize it fully and start repeating it all the time until 2015, 2016, saying racism doesn't exist.
Are you white?
Yes, I'm white.
Okay.
Yeah. But have you noticed that a lot of blacks have this judgment against whites, and they're all into their own race. They're all into their blackness. They're like so proud to be black, they think. Or they try, or they're embarrassed sometimes.
Don't you hear white people saying white pride and then
very rarely.
Like,
very rarely. Blacks on the whole, it's all about kissing up to the blacks and the black identity and black this and black that.
The liberals are doing that. Your people are doing that. The white liberals are doing that.
So are the blacks.
No, the liberals.
There are many blacks who are falling for this stuff.
But
they voted for you guys, you people. I know you didn't. I know you didn't because you were too young and also you're too sensible. But you people voted for Obama 96% twice. 96% of black voters who voted in the presidential elections voted for Obama twice.
All right, but
because he's black.
What's the majority of the race that did vote Obama?
White, because whites are like five times as many whites as blacks in America. Exactly. Are you aware that there are five times as many supposedly whites as there are blacks in America? There's like 40. There's like 45 million blacks, right? Something like that. There's like 197 million whites.
You can't just count black people. You have to count all the immigrants at the time.
I know you can't just count white people. There, you have to count all the Jews and Italians and Irishmen and all these phony people who call themselves white, but they're not Christians. You have to count those too.
All right, they vote Obama.
And actually, Hispanics are counted as white too. What the heck? It's watering down. It's watering down America. Anyway, man.
First of all, wait. They voted Obama twice because they thought that was right for them. Now, I don't personally.
No, because he's black and liberal. He supports evil, and he's black. That's everything that blacks love.
No one knew what he was about. No one knew what he was about.
Then why did they support him? Because they're suckers.
Because they want to see, like, the first black president. Now, the second time, you
exactly.
blame them for being there. The second time, you can't criticize them for the first time they voted him. Criticize them for the when they
people
voted
are,
the
people
time.
Are saying your audio is messed up. You keep on, like, brushing up against things and making noise and stuff. Are you on a... You have, like, earbuds in or something? What the
no,
heck?
No. Am I clearer now?
Oh, yeah, that's maybe clearer now. I don't know. Not really. It's actually the same thing, and you keep on scratching, too, man. Anyway... I love talking with you, Victor. Appreciate you calling in.
All right, Hank. Well, one more thing.
How old are you?
20. One more thing.
Go for it.
Beta.
Take care. Dang, you got me. Man, you even got Chris laughing. He's laughing hard. Victor. Appreciate you, man. Wow. Wrecked. Let me get to Dr. ADD. Ricky in Stockton, California. He has a couple of what he calls hot seat questions for me. Go for it.
Yep.
Hey.
Hey, you're on hot seat. Here we go. Have you ever been arrested?
Declined to answer.
Did you or do you currently own a Game Boy?
No.
Did you ever see the ruins of Atlantis? They were, it's more of a general question, really. Have you ever seen any of the other pictures?
Not real ones, no.
Do you think the Noah's Ark could have been a sphere?
No.
Now, the last two are more of a either or.
All right.
Tesla or Edison?
Ooh. 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 Edison.
And old Biden or whatever current form of Biden is taking now.
Old Biden by a long shot.
Heck yes.
Appreciate it, man. That's kind of fun.
Where'd he go?
Yeah.
That's it, man.
Appreciate it. Nice to hear from you, Ricky. Dr. ADD.
Shout out to the Twitch chat again.
Yes, shout out to Twitch. Head pats, please, says Tesla. Yeah, a lot of you guys are saying Tesla. A lot of you. In fact, most of you guys are saying Tesla. That's funny. All right, man. Appreciate it. It's good to hear from you.
Yep.
All right, take care. Happy Men's History Month, too.
Yeah, happy Men's History Month.
All right. Let me get to Jeremiah in Louisiana. He's been on hold forever as well. Jeremiah, thank you for holding, man. Appreciate your patience. Go on.
What's up, man?
Hey.
Happy Men's History Month to you.
Thank you. Same to you.
And may the best man win, huh?
In terms anyways. Of this call?
Anyways. Whatever. I want to talk about Psalm 73 with you for a second.
Psalm 73. Okay. Yeah. Go for it.
Talked a little bit about, okay, so... And verse 3, it says, for I was envious at the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked, right? Would you agree with that?
Would I agree that is a verse. That is the verse, yes.
No, that's just one verse.
Right.
Because me personally, I was jealous at the foolish when I saw the wicked prosper.
Right.
When you see the wicked prosper, you're like, dang, like, how are they winning? And you know what I'm saying?
What version do you like? King like, KJV? You like King James?
Yeah, KJV, yeah.
Right on.
Yeah, I like King.
Was he black?
That's verse. Say what now?
Was King James black or white?
That's a whole other topic. Yes, yes, he was, but that's a whole other topic.
All right, go on.
What I'm saying is like how Biden. You know how Biden is. You don't agree with Biden, but you agree that he's winning, right? Like they're taking over. The wicked's taking over.
In a worldly sense, yes, it looks like they're winning, but spiritually they're losing.
They're losing.
Yeah,
right.
Go on.
Right. Okay, so it says, for there are no bands in their death, but their strength is firm, right?
Okay.
So it says,
what does that mean?
They are not troubled.
No bands. There are no bands in their death, but their strength is firm. Let me go back to a different version just to see what they're saying. Mm-hmm. I grew up with NIV. I'm not a liberal. I promise I'm not a liberal. My mother gave me an NIV. Maybe she's a liberal.
You know, Hank, I'll give you a little bit more credit than Jesse, because you actually talked to me. He won't. It's crazy.
Oh, come on. Okay, snake. Serpent.
I'm really, that's what the serpent told Eve
when he tried to talk to Adam, and he couldn't talk to Adam, so he went to Eve and said, "You're reasonable, Eve. Go to the weaker vessel."
Is that what he said?
I'm playing around, but maybe, probably. They have no struggles. Their bodies are healthy and strong. Okay, go for it.
Okay, so they are not in trouble as other men, neither are they plagued like other men, right? Therefore, pride compasseth them about as a chain. So the pride of these men is basically their slavery. In Obadiah chapter 1, verse 3, it says that the pride of thine heart.
They're proud because they're doing well in life, they think, and so they're becoming prideful. Okay.
Right. So the pride of thy heart had deceived you. Thou dwellest in the cliffs of the rocks whose habitation is high. Thou said in his heart, who shall bring me down to the ground?
What verse? Is this? I'm trying to follow along.
Obadiah.
Oh, okay.
We'll go back to Psalms. So that's just the pride of these men. Say, who's gonna bring me down, right? Who's gonna bring me down, right? Their eyes stand out with fatness. They have more than their heart could wish, right? You have more than your heart could wish. Your eyes bulge out with fatness because you want more, right?
Okay.
All right. They are corrupt and speak wickedly concerning oppression. They speak loftily. I hear that a lot from your mouth, Hank. Right. Therefore, they set their mouth against the heavens, which they do, and their tongue walketh through the earth. You know what that means?
No.
That means your doctrine, your Christian doctrine that's out there right now, that's walking through the earth right now. Therefore, his people return hither.
How is my Christian doctrine walking through the earth? Explain that.
Because 80-90% of your Christian doctrine is all through the earth. Everybody follows that doctrine. That's not the truth. It's not the true doctrine of the Bible.
Like, name part of the doctrine that walks through the earth that the JLP says
Christ is white. That Christ is white.
I never said Jesus is white or not.
They cover.
That's so shallow. Anyway, go on.
They cover the judges' faces. Now, the judges of the book are the prophets. Would you agree?
Some of them, yeah. I think that, some of them were
judges. And the main judge would be Christ, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And who changed him from his original to what we see today?
Oh, you're talking about black versus white?
I mean,
is this the Jesus truth, black
the truth,
thing?
The truth is in the book. That's why we always say read the book. You can't go off of what people tell you. You got to read the book.
Why does it even matter whether Jesus is black or white?
I caught you saying that Christ was brown last time I spoke with you. You know that?
He's olive.
Said, no, he's olive. He's olive. You said he's brown, and then you switched it to olive.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe so.
Yeah, you did.
All right.
So it's good that you see that, Hank. It's good that you see that. I'm glad that you see that.
Everybody knows Jesus was olive. He was Ashkenazi Jewish.
No, you said brown. You said brown.
Well, I may have, but I totally misspoke. Usually I call him Olive because he's an Ashkenazi. Oh, no, he was Galilean. We know what he would have looked like. He'd have looked like Mediterranean person, like Greek or Sicilian, olive skin.
You know what the color of people back then was, of those people? So how was Egyptian
pure white?
White but
pure
everybody
white.
Around.
Hey,
how was
Let me ask you one more question. regard, because you said, I know this is a totally different topic, but you said King James is black. So Asmodorus asks, please ask this person to explain how the King of Scotland, who ascended to the throne of England, was black.
We were everywhere. Scots means Scots. Scots, not Scottish, but Scots is actually, we're actually black people. The leprechauns that people like to make fun of and stuff, when they had, it was a movie. I can't remember what the movie was, but the invaders of that land were killing leprechauns. You know what leprechauns were?
Nope.
They were considered monsters. You know, brutes and all this type of stuff. All the movies that y'all have, whether it be Remember the Alamo, Rebirth of a Nation, all the movies that y'all have depict us as monsters or animals or brutes.
Oh, so you were leprechaun monsters.
Well, y'all
in our portrayal,
animals.
We portrayed you guys as leprechaun monsters.
Right. Y'all portray us as monsters. You know,
So were the blacks colonizers back then and then we overthrew you?
No, we weren't colonizers. We were indigenous to these lands.
You were everywhere?
Yeah, we were everywhere.
So how come blacks can be everywhere, but whites can't be in the Middle East and Africa?
Because America. Your people were subjected to one part of the world. Y'all were in Mount Seir. Y'all were in, I want to say, Jordan. It was like south of Judea.
Is that because we were
like
God's
that?
Chosen people?
No.
And he allowed us to take over and subjugate you?
No.
According to most black Hebrew Israelites, God put us over you.
Because he used you as a sword. We disobeyed. It was our fault.
So God did it, right?
Believe me when I say it was our fault that we rejected God and went into y'all's false God.
So how come you blame us for imaginary racism?
Because you guys were not supposed to do what y'all did. You weren't supposed to take it as far as you did, and y'all did that.
But we were so nice. But we were the nicest slave owners imaginable.
When we were talking about Babylonian captivity and Roman captivity and Egyptian captivity and all these other slaveries or whatever.
Yeah.
You got, and even
was Egypt blacks enslaving blacks? Because you people think Egyptians were black too, right?
It definitely is. But in those times, our nation, when Christ said, I was only sent to the lost sheep from the house of Israel, he was talking to a black lady. It was African.
How come you're so into your race?
I'm not into race. It wasn't a racial thing. It's about nationality.
Same thing. How come you're so into your nationality?
No, it's not the same thing.
Yes, it is.
Because
nation is another word for race, kind of.
Listen to what I'm about to tell you. I can be of a different nation.
How come you're so into the physical?
Hold on.
Go ahead.
I can also be someone of another nation that's also black, and we're not the same nation. It's not the same thing.
Right, because you're not Africans. The Africans are black.
No, I'm not.
And then you guys are Israelites. Hebrew Israelites.
Exactly. It's East Indians that are black, right?
So which one is the
East
Negro?
Indians that are blacker than me. But they say, no, I'm not black. I'm East Indian. They know the difference between nationality.
Well, the Indians are called Asians by some.
They're not called black. They're not called black. They're called Indians.
So you were the original leprechauns.
You just gotta recognize the points that I'm giving you, Hank.
Answer my question. How come you're so into the physical and not spiritual whatsoever?
How come your spirit is wicked? I'm not sent. Christ said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
And so you're a lost sheep?
The lady that he was speaking to was black. She was not of his nation, though. Right?
Why are you so into the physical?
He may have healed her daughter.
Answer my question, man. Why are you so into the physical?
I'm not into the physical, Hank.
Oh, okay. You're blind.
It's not about
you don't even know yourself. Everybody can see that you're all into being black, and this is just compensation because you're
the Psalm 17
10 minutes
that I'm giving you right now is spiritual. This is your this
10
is
minutes
your spirit.
Till the treasure chest, guys.
I'm reading your spirit to you right now, but you want
no,
to
no, you're
go
not you're reading the
subject.
Bible and putting meaning into it that's not there.
Subject. You went into all this King James and want the why do you go into race? I wasn't going into that. You went into that.
I went
you
into said, that because you're into it. I happen to know that you're into it.
You know, I was sticking to Psalm 73. I am reading your spirit to you in detail. And okay. You didn't want to hear it. You want to deflect to something else.
Let me tell you.
You want me to go back to something?
Let me tell you why. Because other people can see you more clearly than you can see yourself. Asmodor says from trovo.live/thehakereport, it is a special type of inferiority complex to make up an obviously false nonsense to claim others' accomplishments and great men. Collar does this because blacks have no great accomplishments. And I will add that you identify with your blackness. That's why you're stuck in this black Hebrew Israelite nonsense.
Man, we created much of the stuff. Y'all, the only thing y'all created was
you
the
did office. Not create
That's
anything.
All y'all
You did not. What have you created?
That's all you invented to steal everybody else's invention.
What have you created?
Just for a second.
What have you created?
Okay. My people have created a lot.
But what have you created?
What have you created, Hank?
Nothing. Nothing.
Psalm 73.
Nothing. Jeremiah. Right? I answered the question.
Can we get back to Psalm 73?
No, you cannot because you're stuck on this question. You won't answer it directly. You said we created everything. What did you create?
Me personally?
Yes.
Me, nothing. I haven't created nothing. But I'm opening your eyes. So I'm creating life.
And when we celebrate white history, hold on, Jeremiah.
Jeremiah, it's a hierarchy.
Jeremiah, you got to calm down. Hang on. We're having a conversation. When I celebrate white history, I honor the people who actually did something. And that's something that we need to return to, that greatness that we need to return to. But you think it's we because you identify with those people when you have no identity with those people. Those people were better than you.
So you're talking about the patent office. Okay. Anyway,
the patent office.
Back to something.
I gotta go. What a waste of time. He's not hearing. Ears to hear, but does not hear. Let me get to Mike in Las Vegas, Nevada. He wants to talk about this event by the MyPillow guy. Mike in Las Vegas, first time caller. How are you?
Hey, can you hear me all right?
No, I cannot hear you well at all. It is like you're on a speakerphone and not even close to this phone. Come to regular phone.
Is that better?
Yes, thank you.
Hey, no, they got I was calling because it's hard to get the word out with this. The MyPillow guy, Mike Lindell, he was trying to advertise for this event on Fox News last week, and they denied his commercial. And I've seen the commercial. It doesn't say anything bad in it at all.
And, are you going to get me banned off of YouTube by promoting some event?
I'm going to try to keep it vague. How does that sound?
So you're trying to advertise an event for Mike Lindell?
I just wanted to let people know about it.
Can you send it to me so that if Fox News kicked it off, then how is the Hake Report going to air it? I'm more kosher than Fox News.
When they denied his commercial, he pulled all $50 million a year in advertising from Fox News. That's why you don't see the MyPillow commercials anymore.
I haven't noticed. But send me the info, man. Send me the info. Because I'd rather not advertise it because I don't really know Mike Lindell that well. And plus, like, if Fox News is censoring it, how is my channel going to stand?
They're all trying to censor it. Like when
you exactly.
Google it this morning, yeah, it's just hard to find. That's why I didn't want to say anything specific.
I appreciate that, man.
Two-hour event.
I appreciate that. TheHakereport@gmail.com.
All right, I'm going to send it to you here shortly. I've been watching it this morning, man. It's, you know, I'm not a conspiracy.
Are you also Joel Never Did That or something?
I am.
Nice.
I am.
Nice to hear from you. Thank you for the support, as always, Mike. I appreciate you.
Yeah,
I'm sorry,
I
can't do the. Oh, you're gonna be there.
Oh yeah, come on, man. I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Men's conference, the 11th annual men's conference.
Oh yeah, I'll see y'all backstage too, man. I'm
right on. Well, so, I appreciate it, Mike.
Yeah,
it's great to hear.
I didn't want to get too specific, but I definitely wanted to.
When is it happening?
It's going on right now for the next 72 hours straight.
Oh, okay, cool. Is it one of those frankspeech.com things?
Yes.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, check it out. I get alerts from the Frank Speech thing. It's frankspeech.com?
Oh, yeah.
Is that what it is?
Yes.
Yeah,
I
signed up for Frank Speech, and I get email alerts. I've never gone over and perused the site. I've taken a glance at videos that he's puts out, and mm-hmm. I like the guy. I do wonder whether he's gone off of the deep end a little, but I really don't know.
Yeah, you know, and you know, you can't help but, you know, when you're watching yourself, you got to make sure that you're not going off the deep end.
Right.
But so when I watch it really cautiously.
Okay.
You know, because, you know, like I got friends that send me all kinds of crap, you know, like conspiracy this and that, and, you know, without hard evidence. But I guess that's what they're trying to do here. And, you know, I respect the guy in the sense that he's given up a lot as well. Like when I looked at Donald Trump and seen how much money he lost, you know, becoming president and trying to do the right thing. And I was like, you know, in the beginning when people were like, oh, you know, he's this and he's that. I'm like, dude, think about it. It's like the guy had everything.
Yeah.
He had power, money,
yep.
Connections. Everybody loved him. I'm like, put yourself in his shoes. Like, what more could he possibly want other than to leave a good legacy?
Right.
Like, he has no other motivation, and all the money he's lost to do this and you know, all these smears against him and his family, and Mike Lindell's following suit, man. Like, that guy's, you know, last time I looked, he had a net worth of $100 million or more.
Wow. Yeah. I appreciate, I think he cares about America. That's
yeah.
Cool.
And I don't know about, you know, wearing his gold cross everywhere, but, you know, that's, he can do him, you know.
Yeah.
Whatever, I'm not going to judge him, but, no, I mean, yeah, I definitely want him to get the word out, because I've been watching it this morning, and it's kind of interesting.
Okay. Well, I appreciate it, Mike. It's great to hear from you. We'll see you later this week, man, this weekend.
So you don't need me to send you the info at this point. You can find it, right?
Yeah, it's frankspeech.com, right? Happening now. Cool.
Yep.
Thanks, man.
All right.
Take care.
Hey, thank you, Hake, man. Hey, man, we really appreciate everything you guys do, and I hope to be more involved with you guys in the future.
Right on. All right, Mike. Alrighty. Happy Men's History Month to you.
Happy Men's History Month, Mr. Hake.
Thank you. Okay, guys, I'm going to try to get to all of the calls, but first, and we have 8 minutes to go, and in 3 minutes, I'm opening the treasure chest. Let me play this clip 12. This I saw on a shout out to Asmodor. He has the crypto report over there on Telegram, and he shares some interesting stuff. Every now and then, there's something like, oh my gosh, it's graphic, because there's some horrific crimes going on sometimes. But, interesting information oftentimes to be found. Clip 12. This is from foreign TV. It is in Spanish, so I will have to translate. Some of you guys do know Spanish, but if you're watching, you can read the translation on the TV screen, and then afterwards I'll translate it for the podcast listeners. This is President AMLO. AMLO is his AMLO, that is his, like, an abbreviation of his name. He has like four different names, right? AMLO is short for something López Obrador, something like that, right? The president of Mexico. And then he's the one who said, abrazos, no balazos, which is hugs, not bullets. Only in Spanish it rhymes, right? Oh, it's Andrés Manuel López Obrador. That's the president of Mexico. And then also later on, his health secretary, I guess, speaks. His health secretary is Hugo López-Gatell Ramírez. And they both talk about, actually, they talk some sense about Big Pharma, the pharmaceutical companies who made these so-called vaccines. Speaking some sense in Spanish. Some of you guys understand it. I shall translate. Enjoy this clip. It's about 2 minutes long, give or take. Listen to this.
Hay que tener cuidado, porque como es lógico, las farmacéuticas quieren hacer negocio y quisieran pues estar vendiendo siempre vacunas. Para todos, pero tenemos que priorizar, tenemos que saber si se requieren, no se requieren, no estar sometidos, sujetos, subordinados a que las farmacéuticas sean las que nos digan, falta una tercera dosis, falta una cuarta dosis, falta que se vacunen los niños.
Hay una poderosa podríamos decir, campaña de opinión inducida por las compañías farmacéuticas. Si uno explora la prensa, no solamente nacional, sino internacional, y rastrea una recomendación, como pueden ser estas, lo que puede ver es que hay una importante carencia de información científica que apoye una recomendación de esta naturaleza, y en contraste hay declaraciones de, sobre todo, los gerentes generales de las compañías farmacéuticas productoras de vacunas, que ya lo dan por un hecho.
Crazy, huh? So, in translation, AMLO, who's older than I remember, says we need to be careful because it's logical that pharmaceutical companies will want to make a profit. That's the president of Mexico speaking, who said hugs, not bullets, which is not very logical, but this part is. And those pharmaceutical companies would like to keep always selling vaccines for everybody. We need not be subject and subordinate to their dictation. They're dictating us, these pharmaceutical companies. We need to prioritize and know if people need the thing or not. Yeah, we're opening the treasure chest right now, guys. Over there on DLive. Big chest. Big chest. We need a... This is the type of things that the pharmaceutical companies might say, he says. We need a third dose. We need a fourth. We need to vaccinate children. Booster shots, right? Los niños. And so his health secretary, Hugo López-Gatell Ramirez, says there's a powerful public opinion campaign pushed by the big pharmaceutical companies. If no one if one explores the national and international big media, mainstream media, and traces recommendations, one can perceive an important lack of scientific basis to support the recommendations that they have. But the big pharma executives are pushing the same thing that the mainstream media are doing, and it's all taken for granted. Crazy, huh? Telling the plain, obvious truth. Wasn't that nice? Thank you, Mexico. Yeah, that was a nice treasure chest, finally. It's been like 2 months, so you guys got quite a chest. Misty got 249 lemons, says Super Dave. Wow. Anyway, let me get to Chuck in Detroit, Michigan. He's been on hold forever. Chuck, how are you doing?
I'm doing all right.
Oh, man, your phone is messed up, Chuck. You know what, Chuck? Call me tomorrow. We are out of time. I appreciate you holding on there. Yeah, well, talk to me tomorrow, man. I appreciate it. T and the rest of the callers, T from Alabama, wanted to ask if I was racist or if I'm just playing. I guess T thinks racism exists still. Anyway, I got one more song for you. And we are a couple minutes till, but this song is so long, I have to start it now. This is Stavesacre, 1999, from the album Speakeasy. This is called Freefall, parentheses, from hand to hand. Interesting, huh? Is it like God is passing you from one hand to the other? I don't know exactly what it means, but it's a nice, moody, supposedly Christian song. Liberal, fake Christian. Enjoy. I know I will. And hopefully I'll see you tomorrow, guys. Thanks, and take care. Spinning here.
trust